I'm gonna show you the right way to use effects with PowerDirector. Let's make something special. I have a clip of a gentleman getting jiggy with it, and I wanna add some effects to spice things up a bit. So I'm gonna go up here to the effects room. I'm gonna go to style effect. I'm gonna go to AI object selection. Now here I'm gonna go ahead and use Ghost 2. I'm gonna left click, hold down my left mouse button, and I'm gonna drag it down to the first clip. Now I wanna change the color of this, and I wanna change the distance and a few other things. So I'm gonna click on effect. I'm gonna click on color. And I'm just gonna select red. You can choose any color under the rainbow. I'm gonna click on OK. And I wanna go ahead and change the distance on this. So I'm going to go all the way over to the right to 200. So I'm gonna close this out. And now I want there to be another ghost on the right-hand side of this individual. So you can't add the same effect twice. So what I'm gonna do to fix that is I'm gonna right-click on the clip. I'm gonna go to copy. I'm gonna right click on track two. I'm gonna do paste. So it's gonna add the exact same clip right below it. So if I double left click on it, it'll open up the PIP designer. And here I can go to object settings. If it's not open, you just click it and open it up. I'm gonna go to opacity and I'm gonna change it to 50%. Now I'm gonna close this out by clicking on okay. And now I need to change the effect because I need to move it over and I need to change the color. So I'm gonna left click on effect. I'm gonna change the color to green. And I'm gonna change the direction. Puts it on the other side. And everything should be good here. So I'm gonna go ahead and close this out. And now I wanna go ahead and add some effects to the background and the foreground of a clip. So I'm gonna left click on the second clip on the timeline. And I'm gonna drag contour one down to this clip. I'm gonna go to effect. And I'm gonna change the size to 30. Hit enter. Close this out. And I also wanna add a pulse. So I'm gonna go to motion trail pulse one, hold down my left mouse button. I'm gonna drag it down to clip two. And now I wanna go ahead and change up the background. So I'm gonna go to style. And I'm going to use the pencil sketch. I'm gonna left click it, hold down my left mouse button and drag it down to the second clip. Now I'm gonna click on effect. And I don't want this to be on him and the background. I just want it to be on the background. So I'm gonna click on pencil sketch. I'm gonna click on auto select mask prominent object. So now it's gonna add the mask to just the man. So if I just wanted him to be a cartoon, I could leave it like this, but I want it to be on the background. So I'm going to check this box that says invert masked area. So now the man is the regular film and the background is changed to the pencil sketch. So I'll close this out. You can add transitions between the clips to make the effect stand out even more. And you can learn how to do that by watching this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.